You all are looking at Tilt McGillis. He's an aspiring country singer. Only problem is, he lives in bumfucked Egypt, Grnion County to be more precise, and he's hoping to be discovered one day. But right now, he's in a whole heap of trouble.
All right, Tilt, I'm not gonna lie to you. I suspect you might have had something to do with what happened to Ricky Weston last night. Now, I thought about calling your mom, but I know she'd be worried sick if she found out you might be doing jail time, and I don't want to do that to her. She's a good woman. So it's just going to be me and you, Tilt, man to man. I want you to go ahead and tell me what happened last night.
Officer Bollinger! Listen here, motherfucker. Ricky Weston's balls were already on fire when I got to that party. Hell, if it wasn't for me tossing my last beer on his genitals, he'd be walking around without any nuts. I think you owe me an apology instead of giving me a third degree.
Well, your friends Bud and Wayne told me they saw you stacking charcoal briquettes around Mr. Weston's scrotum last night. What was that, Tilt?
All right, Officer Bollinger. Maybe I did light his balls on fire. Hell, I was just trying to wake him up. I didn't mean to hurt him. Those balls are pretty durable, you know. I've dropped ratchets and books and all kinds of things on mine, and they're pretty sturdy. You know, I didn't think fire was gonna hurt him.
Tilt, did you hear what you just said? You just gave me a fifth-word speech on your balls. And that's not what I wanted to hear. I want you to go ahead and decide what kind of punishment you think you deserve for this crime. Now, most people wouldn't get this chance, but hell, Tilt, I've known you since you were knee-high to a goat, and I like you. Everybody in Grnion County likes you. So I'm gonna cut you a little bit of slack. You go ahead and decide for yourself what kind of punishment you think you deserve.
I'm on level with you, Officer Bollinger. I have a fondness for practical jokes. All started with my Uncle Cooter. He introduced me to the classics like the dog turd and the salad and the goat spray bit and countless others. But I got a weakness. I can't pass up a good practical joke, you know? And I didn't want to hurt Ricky Weston. He's one of my best friends, you know. I didn't mean to hurt him. Maybe I'll go by there later. I'll take him some bag bomb and some beer and try to make up for it. You know, I didn't want to piss him off.
All right, Tilt. Just don't let it happen again. Go on and get out of here now. Tell your mother I said hi.
I will, Officer Bollinger. I promise. I'll be good. I promise. See you later, motherfucker. Sorry I left you out here so long. Boy, you're looking awful hot today. Nobody around, we're all alone. Oh.
Smoother than a nun's ass.
yeah! Hey, Andy Jr.,
you little cocksucker.
Boozing, baby.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, what the fuck's going on?
Motherfucker.
Yep, you guessed it, that's Ricky Weston. And after having his nuts lit on fire, he's not too happy. And I don't blame him, because that probably hurts.
I ain't good enough.
Never forget that night. October 31st, 1976. It was a cold, dark night. I look outside my back window. There's a fire. What do? I had to put it out before it got to the cabin. I go outside. I start to stomping. Next thing you know, limp bag of shit in a bear trap. Phew. Ah, there's to you, boy.
Fucking armadillo's fucked up my garden again.
It's been digging up my garden. Say your prayers, you little prick cocksucker!
I'll be goddamn thing to squash that little shit ass.
You turn on me.
You little cock-eating little fucking piece of goddamn son of a bastard shit.
This here's Grnion County's resident stud. Rumor is he's got a pecker as big as a baseball bat. Just ask any of the girls in Grnion County. And the only thing bigger than his pecker is his ego.
Fucking jock that sleeps here every day. This calls for the old fun box.
Thank you. much deserved tanning nap. What do you think? Just what I thought.
What are you doing?
Oh, just nothing.
Did you make me sweat my wets? I mean, wet my sweats?
Oh, no, that wasn't me. That was somebody else. I just seen
fuck?
If you're all right.
What the fuck is this? What the fuck you doing with that ball? What the fuck is that?
I just gonna throw it away, buddy.
Yeah, right, you fucking skinny hick motherfucker.
Hey, buddy. Chill out now. Well, I guess I'll be going now.
Yeah, right. The fuck you think you're doing?
My goddamn tire gate.
Is this what you're looking for, motherfucker?
Yeah, it is, buddy. Where'd you get that?
You just don't fucking worry about it. Are you the one that fucking made me piss my sweats or not?
No, that wasn't me. No.
I think you're lying, you dirty piece of cocksucker.
Nobody calls Tilt McGillis a liar, motherfucker. You may not have heard of me, but I'm gonna be a real big country star someday, and I guarantee goddamn you're gonna know my name. So you best be on your fucking way, motherfucker. Morning, Red. Hey, didn't you say you were gonna buy me breakfast?
Here's your goddamn breakfast, Tilt.
Oh, motherfucker. Thanks for breakfast.
You believe some prick had the audacity to call me a liar today?
I just forget about it.
Oh, well, I would, but the whole incident is caused to flare up.
Oh,
you got that air pillow around here anywhere?
Oh, as a matter of fact, there you go.
Oh, yeah. That's my baby. Yeah, I'll have to use that today. Hey, what do you got for me today?
Got a couple new cars out there. I need you checking a PSI reading out there for me, if you could.
I'll get it done. You can count on me.
Thanks, Bill.
Be back in a minute, Red.
Get the fuck out of here, you little brat.
Fucking cocksucker peeing on my tires.
Better than a good PSI reading.
Didn't I tell you to get out of here, you little fucking brat?
Red. That PSI readings are A-OK on all them motherfuckers.
All right.
Hey, got anything else for me?
Yeah, is the dog pissing on them tires again?
Oh, yeah. Stinky as fucking hell, little bastard. By the way, I saw Chrislders out there the other day kicking tires. If I catch that little prick, he's number one on my kick list.
No shit?
Yep.
I'll keep an eye out for him.
Need me for anything else?
Nah, I think that's about it, man. I'll give you a couple doggies, some beer money.
All right, man.
I'll see you on Monday.
Yeah?
Here you go, buddy.
Yeah, okay.
Appreciate it, Till.
No problem. I tell my mom you said hi.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm going to take my fucking air pillow, buddy. Probably going to need that. See you later, brother.
Tilt's about to find something that's going to turn him to stone. In certain regions, that is.
I see what I think I just saw. Jiminy Christmas. Goodness, that's a whole lot of rosy. I must be losing my goddamn mind. I'm out here in the middle of the woods talking to a fuck book.
About the guy goes to the bar, orders 12 beers.
No, let's hear it.
Anyways, this guy walks up to the bar, sits down, and says, "Bartender, give me 12 beers. So I'm celebrating my first blowjob." The bartender says, "Well, hell, I'm gonna give you 13. There's one on me." He goes, "Well, you know, I think 12's enough to wash the taste out of my mouth."
Jesus, that sure makes my pecker stiff. That shit should be outlawed. Women that good looking shouldn't be walking out on the street, let alone taking pictures. God damn.
Hey, Jim. This is JD. You got your ears on it?
Yeah, go ahead, DD.
Hey, did your boys get that cable trench down across the road? You know that's gotta come up through there.
Yeah, 10-4 JD, we're sweating bullets over here. Oh, man. We could use a couple more guys, actually.
Okay, I feel like I'm going to try to send a couple more guys down, but we got to get that fixed up as soon as we can. And another thing, if you see my Pampers magazine running around over there, kick out that for me, would you? Because I think I might have found it in my pocket.
Yeah, 10-4, JD. We see a Plumpers laying around here. It's all yours.
Hey, I appreciate that, buddy.
JD is Plumpers. He likes biggins, you know.
Woo, baby.
Here comes another car. We're going to go ahead and flag it down.
Oh, baby. Oh, I'm on a cream. Hey, this guy ain't gonna stop. Oh, baby. Get out of the way, dude! Oh, baby. Oh, yeah.
Jesus Christ, Dave. Are you okay? Damn, some bitches. You gotta watch where you're fucking going. I'll be walking to
it. We better get this dish done before JV gets here.
Oh. Oh. I better go home and wring the DNA out of my drawers. What the hell's that rattling? The fuck?
Better take this shit.
Hell.
That goddamn Ricky Weston's been fucking with my car again.
how you doing?
I'm doing fine.
You got home early?
Yeah, I got off work early. I'm gonna go head over to Bud and Wayne's later.
Well, don't rush off so quick. I don't have much time to see you these days. Would you working on your car and running around with Bud and Wayne?
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I'm gonna go over to Bud and Wayne's later. I just got too many irons in the fucking fire right now.
Now, Tilt, what did I tell you about using dirty language like that in the house?
You never said nothing about that.
I know that, Tilt. I was just giving you a hard time. I think I've been a pretty good mother, teach you right from wrong.
Oh, yeah.
Make a difference.
Yeah, you have, Mom. Hell, I don't get in half the shit Bud and Wayne do.
Well, you just make sure it stays that way. Sometimes I think that Bud and Wayne have been sprawned by the devil. Speaking of them two, the McCormick comics called, and they have missing a chicken, and they think they have something to do with that.
Oh, I doubt that.
Well, Mr. Albrighter said he seen Bud running down Mill Creek this morning with a picnic basket in his hand, giggling like a little kid.
Oh, Mr. Albrighter's got an angry corn cob up his ass ever since Bud and Wayne threw cow dung on him Halloween.
Well, enough of that, Tilt. Are you hungry, honey?
Oh, yeah. Darn tootin'.
Well, how does Rocky Mountain sound?
Oh, that sounds delicious.
All right, I'll get you some.
All right. I'm gonna go wash up. Mom, could you make them to go? I gotta meet up with Bud and Wayne in about 5 minutes.
Can't you stay a while?
Oh, no, I'm kind of in a hurry. I gotta go out and feed the animals, okay?
All right, would you feed chickens?
Yep, sure.
All right.
Feeding time. Come on there, buddies. Chow time, motherfuckers. Lester, you cocky son of a bitch. Quit dry humping that goat.
Morning, little
cat. Sitting on the dock of the bay. Rise and shine, little fishies. Come and get it. Papa's here. Cocksuckers. Just have to give them the goods. Good shit. Oh, you greasy little fucking cockroach. Come and get it. Ah, you little peckerhead. When you gonna let me drive this, Ma?
Never. You better not scratch it. Make sure you don't put no scratches on it now. I want this thing in mint perfect condition. You don't even know how to ride it yet.
You won't ever let me ride it, huh?
Well, you're gonna have to learn how to ride a bicycle before you can ride this.
Okay.
At least a four-wheel
bicycle. Some training wheels on it, that'd be all right.
Well, you gotta ride your training wheel bicycle and learn that first.
Okay.
Oysters there, son.
Okay, thanks, Mommy, for the mountain oysters. I'll make sure I won't throw them at anybody this time.
Well, you make sure you give some of them to Bud and Wayne, leave some for them. Lord knows they need some to soak up some of that alcohol that they have in their body. And I hope that you don't let them give you any. That's the last thing you need to start drinking again.
I'll be good, I promise. See you later. Love you.
Give Mama a hug. Oh, I love you.
Okay, see you later.
Call me.
Chicken. It's Friday, let's go pound some boobs.
Sheriff's out? You know I ain't got no damn money.
Now don't worry about it, man. Tonight the drinking's on me. How's Grnion County whiskey sound, boys?
You want to bring chicken?
Hell no, I ain't got room for that fucking chicken. I ain't got room for that shit. Let's go, guys.
Let's go.
This here's record executive Johnny King. He's in for a big fucking surprise.
Hello. Yes, sir, it's Johnny. Yeah, well, the showcase went pretty good. Yeah, but I just didn't find any that had what we were looking for, you know. A lot of good singers, but just, you know, a lot of them just didn't have that down-to-earth type, you know, feel to it. But, you know, most of them there just had to get the record contract to get rich, you know. But, you know, we got another showcase coming up next month. Yeah, I know. Yeah, I hope we can find somebody, you know, that's worth it. But, yeah, it's in Kansas City. You know, I'm trying, yeah. But, anyways, I'll be back on Monday. But right now I'm going to stop and get a room in the next town. And I'll talk to you when I get back to you. Yeah, I'm working on it. Okay. Tires, let alone a new car. And I ain't got a spare either. Damn it. Fuck. All the fucking batteries are dead. God damn, shit's gotta change.
You got on that bad boy?
I got 15s on there right now.
Oh yeah? What's the max PSI rating on those?
Well, I prefer a 55 maximum PSI regulated ratio tire over a non-regulated tire, because the way the air is densely proportioned throughout the tire and the way it sets on an uneven, unstable road like gravel for better fuel efficiency. I say?
You might be long here, buddy, but you speak my language. Well, help you.
I appreciate it, man.
You help that boy?
Yeah.
You right? Hey, boy. From that new city?
Sure am.
Yeah.
You're ready to go, buddy. 55, just like you wanted it. 55.
You got it there?
Oh, yeah, but.
Oh, man.
Round them out.
How much are you guys?
I could use a deep hemorrhoid, Dickle.
A what?
Oh, it's just bullshit, motherfucker. We're glad to help you out.
That's all right. Well, at least let me give you a little gift. I got a little something you guys may be able to use.
Oh, really?
You guys like country music?
You in a shit?
You fucking right.
You guys
are
like fucking
come on with you.
Yeah, you guys look like the type that like country music.
I
got a little gift for you here.
Hey, this for you.
Wow.
Thanks, man.
Stand up, Tilt.
You can just call me Johnny, Johnny King.
All right, buddy. My name's Tilt. Tilt McGillis. These are my Bud and Wayne.
Hey, what's up, man? What's up?
Nice to meet you. I hear you. Stand up, Tilt.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Yeah, now that boy can play 100 damn songs he's got cooped up in that damn head of his.
I want to be a country music star.
Play one of your original, Nick.
Oh, no shit. You want to hear one of my originals?
Sure.
All right, this one's called Love Dumpin'. Pretty much it. What do you think, Johnny?
That's pretty good, Tilt. You mean to tell me that you've never played guitar before tonight?
No.
And you just come up with these songs and memorize them without writing them down?
That's right, motherfucker.
Damn, Tilt. That's pretty impressive, you know. And I got something surprising to tell you.
Hey, now, buddy, ain't into any of that homosexual stuff.
No.
If you're a goddamn colon cowboy, you can hit the fucking road or you bang Bud or Wayne. I don't give a fuck.
No, actually, what I was going to tell you is I work for a very large record company called Elite Records.
Oh, no shit. I heard of Ewan's. You all got that Leon Turgis on your label, don't you? He's my favorite.
Yes, he is, Till. Ashley, and I got some good news for you, too.
Really?
After hearing you tonight, I'd like to sign you to Elite Records. How about that?
You wouldn't shit Tilt McGillis, would you?
No, I'm pretty serious, Till. Actually, I got the contracts right here in my briefcase. Now, you get a 5-year contract with 5 records and a 7-figure salary. If you just sign
off. Not only yeah, but hell fucking yeah. Woo! You hear that, motherfucker? God damn, get the fuck up. Wake up, motherfucker. I got a record contract, motherfuckers. Wake up.
Let's take a look at these
Tilt. You shitting? All right, JK.
You what?
Oh, hell.
Hey. Look at this boy here. Oh, man. Made it. And you get it,
baby. Let's see here.
Let's see here.
Oh, yeah. That's all typed up professional-like.
Of course.
Ain't fucking around.
You'll need to sign here.
I have some stipulations. Ow. Stipulations right here.
You got too much.
We can work everything
that's
out.
That's not going to fly.
We can work everything out later on.
Goddamn ape head.
Room.
Oh, I was out with Bud and Wayne last night.
What'd you do all night?
I just hanging out drinking.
Now tell me what you really did.
Well, all right, Mom. I got a recording contract. I don't want to brag or anything, but you can check it out if you want.
You're really not joking, are you?
No, I'm not joking. Look.
You're not really joking, are you?
No, I wouldn't bullshit. I mean, I wouldn't lie to you. I've always dreamed of being a country star.
Yep, ever since your dad and I bought you that first Leon Truggers album when you were 12 years old. I knew.
Well, this is my big chance, and I don't want to fuck it up. I mean, blow it. The record exec's going to come pick me up tomorrow. I got to drop my car off at Bud and Wayne's. I'm sorry I'm moving so far away, and I'm sorry this is so sudden, but I've always dreamed of this.
Don't be sorry, Tilt. I understand. I always thought I'd hear your golden voice on the radio. Ever since you were a little kid, we used to listen to you. Dad and I used to look at each other, and we knew we someday would be hearing that golden voice on the radio. I'm really proud of you, son. I'm really proud.
I'm glad you're happy, Mom.
Trust me, I couldn't be happier for you. Now, you're just going to have to go upstairs and get some sleep, because I'm sure everybody in the country is going to want you to come over tomorrow and say goodbye to them before you go.
I got to go out the Edge tomorrow and break the news to him about my job. Hope he doesn't get pissed off.
Well, he's just going to have to understand.
Yeah.
You just go get rested.
All right.
He'll have to deal with it.
All right, good night.
Good night.
Morning, Red.
Hey, Mark, so how you doing?
Pretty good. How'd your weekend go?
I know you didn't come here on a Sunday. Just asked me how my weekend was.
No, I didn't.
What, did your mom catch you playing with yourself again, or did you knock up Officer Bollinger's dog?
Well, the first part, but it's worse than that, buddy.
Go ahead.
Not mad at me, and I hope you'll forgive me on down the line for this, but I got a recording contract, and I'm moving to the big city to record an album.
Well, I'm proud of you, too. I could never be mad at you for that. I knew you had too much talent for this one county.
Really?
You'd be here the rest of your life.
Well, I appreciate that, buddy, but I'm gonna miss you. Are you gonna be able to handle all this by yourself?
I'll be fine here by myself. There ain't hardly enough tires in this entire county to keep one person busy. I want you to go and make this county proud on TV. Man, make me proud of you, boy. Go ahead and make something of yourself.
Okay, Red. I'm gonna miss you, buddy.
I'm gonna miss you too, Tilt. And if you ever come back, you know you got a job right here with me.
I appreciate that, Red. Hey, before I go, can I sponge one last beer off your motherfucker?
Man, sure.
All right.
You silly shit.
Thanks, motherfucker.
Hold on, Tilt. Here's one for the room. Go along, buddy.
Hey, yeah.
See you, Tilt.
Well, boys, I guess it's a goodbye. You two to know you're my best friends, and I'm gonna miss both of you.
I'm gonna miss you too.
Oh man,
motherfucker.
You're gonna make me cry, boy.
Oh, I always knew you'd be a star.
You guys are my boys.
We got you a little song.
Oh, did you, man? You didn't have to fucking do that.
Oh, we got you a little song.
What the hell's that? Oh, damn! That's a fucking digital tire
gate. Like that, digital.
Lightweight, too.
Light.
Oh, yeah, my God. I never got such a nice gift. I don't know what to say, man. Well, I was going to leave you guys the keys to my car. You guys can watch my baby for me while I'm gone.
Woo! Keys to the ride! Donut!
Hey, you boys treat that thing fucking nice. If anything happens to that, my boots got a fucking one-way flight to your fucking anus. You got me?
Gotcha. Do speed limit.
All right.
Got my test drive.
Woo! Ah!
Start!
Woo! What the hell we just did?
Where is him in Knoxville?
Knoxville?
Where is him in Knoxville? We got a new ride! Hey, man! Take care of fucking the game.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. Holy shit. Woo! Our star!
Damn it,
I'm all packed. I'm gonna miss this place. Well, I guess this is goodbye, Mommy.
Well, I'm so proud of you, and I'm really gonna miss you too, son. And if your dad was here, he'd really be proud of you too. And all right. I want you to take this hat.
All right.
A little bit of good luck up there in the big city, wear that.
Thanks, Mom.
and I'll be waiting to hear your golden voice on the radio.
All right, I'm going to make you proud.
Okay, I'll be waiting to hear from you on the radio.
All right, love you, Mom.
All right, I'm going to look out with you. Bye there, Tilt.
All right.
I'm going to miss you, Tilt.
I miss you, too.
I've been listening for you on the radio.
Yep.
This ride's kind of fucking lame. Let's just do something. Let's raise some goddamn hell, motherfucker.
Are you on crazy, buddy? I'll show you what we did back at my home.
Oh, really?
Ready?
Fuck yeah!
Hang on.
Woo! All right, motherfucker. God damn you. This is the shit. Ah, yeah. Woo! Woo! Goddamn ride, motherfucker. Sure gonna miss Bud and Wayne.
Yeah, they really seem like nice guys.
Could you pull over for a minute, Johnny?
Sure, buddy, but something wrong over here?
I've never fucking been this far from home before.
Well, we just left your town about five minutes ago.
I know, but can I just get a minute alone? Just be by myself for a second.
Sure, Till.
Just be a second, man. Grnion County, I'm gonna miss you, motherfucker.
Well, old Tilt's on his way to making his dreams come true. Let's just hope he doesn't fuck it up.
First door on your right. Hello. Oh, hi, Mr. Springfield. Yeah. Yeah, we just got here a little bit ago.
Hold on, dude.
Yeah. Well, I wouldn't worry about a thing. Yeah, we've got, he's got some material written.
Give me the Christmas, dude. Oh.
Yeah, I know, it could cost me my job.
Come on, dude.
Just trust me, all right? Okay. I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye. That's no excuse, Till. From now on, you're only to use the restroom, all right? It's right through there.
All right. Don't get your panties in
the bowl. I won't. Come on, I'll show you the rest of the house.
All right.
Hey, this is where you'll be staying from now on.
Woo!
Talk about artsy-fartsy.
Well, thanks.
Wow. This is nice, man. You got a stove and a fridge and all the accoutrements.
What? Yeah, buddy.
There's one to stay here at my place.
What's that, Johnny?
There's only one bed and it's in my room.
I knew it, you son of a bitch. You're trying to get in my drawers.
No, what I was about to say, Tilda, is you're going to be sleeping on the couch for the time being.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I knew that. I was just bullshitting with you. What time is it anyway?
It's 8:29.
Oh, shit. My favorite show comes on at 8:30.
I'll be in my room, Tilt.
All right, buddy.
squirrel time. Can't miss it. Way to blow that rodent right out of that tree, Jim.
Hey, come out from up there. Hey, boy. He was
I know that some bitch was out here. I saw him through the window. That little agile bastard jumping from tree to tree. Mongrel. No! Oh! Damn, Johnny!
Oh, what in the hell are you doing, Tilt?
I'm trying to eat, goddammit.
Oh, you okay, Squeaky? Goddammit, Tilt! I don't know if living with you is gonna work. You've been here 30 minutes and you pissed in my pool and tried to kill the house pet.
Excuse the hell out of me, I didn't know you had a rat for a pet. And you got one hell of an ego not thinking your pool's too good to be pissed in. And not to mention you got the personality of a pair of cowballs at an ice cream social.
What? That's the dumbest analogy I've ever heard, Tilt. How do you expect somebody famous when you're trying to win an argument with a stupid sentence like that? I'll tell you what, things are done different here in the city than they are in the country. If you don't like it here, you can always go back there.
I've been here 30 minutes and I hate it. You're just like all them other city slickers. Got a corn cob up your ass.
Things are different here in the city, Till. You know, if you don't like it here, you can go back home. And I'm not gonna give you a ride.
You need to get the dick out of your ears because I didn't ask you for a ride, buddy. I'll find my own ride.
Well, fine then. I tell you what, when you walk off or whatever you're gonna do, when you wise up, come knock on my door because you're not gonna find anybody to take you 15 hours back to Grnion County.
We'll see about that, buddy.
Yeah, we'll see.
We will.
Thank you. Tilt, are you here?
What the hell has he got himself into?
You didn't actually think you were gonna drive all the way back to Grnion County, did you?
Yeah, I was aiming to, buddy. I'm sorry I stole your lawnmower there.
I forgive you, Tilt. Tell you what, man, start it up and I'll follow you back home, all right? We'll try it again.
All right, bud. We'll try it again.
All right.
Hey, Mom, it's me. What's going on? Yeah, I made it, all right. Yep, we made it. No problem. Yeah, I miss you too, Mom. All right, I'll talk to you soon. Love you, bye.
Johnny, this is Rod Horner.
Rod from Petty.
How are you, mate?
I'm doing fine. How are you doing?
Yeah, not bad. Actually, I'm out on tour in Europe at the moment with old fucking what's his name, Ernie and the Rebels. Balled out me fucking bollocks, I am. So I thought I'd give you a call to see how things are doing on the home front.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I'd like you to talk to Tilt McGillis. Yeah, the Tilt. Yeah, the one everybody's talking about.
Yeah, put him on. It's always nice to talk to a new member of the family.
Okay, well, hang on. You take care of yourself, all right? Hey, don't be a stranger. Give me a call. Hang on. Tilt!
Yep.
Phone, buddy. It's Rod.
Rod. Hey, Rod, what the fuck's going on?
Hello there, Mr. McGillis. Yeah, Rod Orney. I'll be your tour manager when you get over here in the next few months.
Tour manager from Europe, huh?
Yeah, and one thing that I'll always do with all of my clients is tell them a true story about myself. Just kind of breaks the ice a little bit, do you know what I mean?
Yep.
All right, well, let me see. How about the one where, like, about 5 years back, I was at the Astoria, right, in London. I was down the rock night there, and I pulled this fucking bird. She had fucking legs up to her arse.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, like, I took her back to my gaff, you know, got down to business, and frankly, I was going quite fucking berserk, you know. I was coming all over the fucking place within about 5 fucking minutes, all over her fucking tits. It was bloody marvellous.
No shit.
Anyway, I went to sleep after, you know, a couple of minutes, as you do.
No.
No? Ah, well, anyway, I did. And so anyway, I'm fast asleep there. Woke up with this funny tingling sensation in my knob. And I looked down and my cat was licking my fucking knob.
Huh?
The cat was licking my fucking knob!
Oh, wow. Uh-huh.
Anyway, yeah, do you like that one?
Yep.
All right, Mr. McGillis. Well, it was very nice talking with you and I look forward to seeing you soon on the road.
Well, take care, Rob.
All right, mate. See you then. Bye.
Oh,
this motherfucker.
The fuck's calling me now?
God damn it.
Hello. Yeah, this is me.
Oh,
yeah.
God damn it.
Yeah, we just got here. Yeah, he's in the shitter.
Oh.
Yeah, getting ready to rehearse. Hopefully he's going to get along with these guys here.
Awesome.
I'll call you back later and let you know the details, all right? What are you doing here? Come on, man.
Oh. God damn. Hey, God damn it.
Hurry up, Tilt. Fuck, man.
You fucking retarded.
Fuck, man.
Oh, damn. What are you, a fucking homo or something?
No. We got to get going. I'm just trying to get things going. Here's the deal, man.
Yeah.
Be straightforward with you.
Yeah, motherfucker.
These ain't the greatest musicians in the world, but right now in your career, that's all you got, okay? Just give them a chance, because they're honest, and they'll really work hard, okay? This is all I'm asking. Just give them a chance.
The little thing hold down a honky-tonk beat, and it'll fuck up. I ain't got a problem with little punks.
It'll work
out. You hear what I'm saying, motherfucker?
I hear you. That's good. Good attitude, Till.
Hey, Johnny. You got a beer?
Nah, Till, we've already talked about all that, man. You can't be drinking, man. No more of that.
You ought to be shitting me.
No.
I'll let you just pull my fucking leg for that dick.
Sounds good, guys. Hey, Tilt, this is your guitarist here, Ernie Noodles Cranberg.
Pleasure to meet you, Tilt.
Pleasure's all mine, motherfucker. That's a nice guitar you got there.
Thanks, Tilt.
Ow, motherfucker!
Nice to meet you.
What the fuck's up with this junk?
Calm down, Tilt. He's blind, man.
That's right. He is?
Yeah, that's why the Rhythm Reynolds.
How you doing, motherfucker?
Hey, Tilt.
What?
He's blind, he ain't deaf.
Oh, okay.
And last but not least, over here we have Wando Wad Johnson.
Go on there, Wad.
It's Wando.
God damn. Some bitch house broken?
Well, that's the band, Till.
Yeah. Let's see what you motherfuckers got. 1, 2, 3, 4! Johnny, can I have a word with you outside, buddy?
Sure, Till. Sure.
What the fuck is going on in there, you hippie shit-talking motherfucker? First of all, I can't drink. That goes against everything I stand for. I've been drinking 35 fucking years. And for God's sakes, the drummer's a goddamn retard.
Hey, hold it right there. Now, that drummer happens to be a good friend of mine, you know? I'm not gonna sit around and let you call him a retard, you know? You may not realize this, Till, but we took a fucking big risk with you. You know, the CEO of my record label almost shit when I told him I was taking a former auto mechanic from Grnion County and was going to make him a star. You know, you're getting a chance that only one in a million get in their whole life. So if you want to be a country star, you need to start acting like it.
All right. Just one beer, though?
No beer. Now get in there and practice with those guys.
God damn
expect everything to be perfect the first time. Now try it again.
Better play it right, motherfucker. Here we go!
You got that motherfucker, I'm gonna kill your ass.
Well, Till, I have to admit, practice didn't really go like I expected it to today.
Yeah, I know, man. It didn't, but, you know, we'll just take some time, we'll work the bugs out. I think it's gonna work. I really do.
I hope so, man. I have to apologize to you, you know, I shouldn't have kept you from drinking.
Oh.
You know, what they say is true. An alcoholic from drinking is like trying to keep a baby from shitting all over himself, you know?
This is true.
I know.
But, you know, everybody makes mistakes, motherfucker. We'll try it again tomorrow, right?
I'll toast to that.
All right, man.
Hey, by the way, I got you a little present there sitting outside. You want to go look at it?
Present?
Yeah.
No shit. Hell yeah.
It'll cheer you up a little bit.
Yeah.
Come on.
Right.
You'll like it.
All right.
I think you'll like it. It's in your own well.
Close your eyes now.
Okay, bud.
Come on, can you get your eyes closed?
Yeah.
You still got your eyes closed?
Yeah.
Okay, now look.
Woohoo! Look at that son of a bitch! Goddamn motherfucker, that's fucking hot shit!
Pretty nice, ain't
that's fucking s***. Thick as a dog dick.
Good wagon.
Looks the same.
I want to check the air, though.
Miss the old bitch.
Oh, you want to check the air? Tony, this is the nicest thing anybody's ever done for me.
Anything for you, Till.
Yeah, all right, bud. Thanks, man.
You know my body.
She's just beautiful as ever.
Sure is,
Till. All right. Don't get your panties in a wad. Yep.
Hello, is this Tilt?
Yeah.
My name is Oliver, but you can just call me the Bronze Barbarian.
Oh, hey, how's it going there, Bronze Barbarian?
Indeed, I'm a very good friend of Rod Burns, and I'm going to be your guitar tech on the forthcoming tour, man.
You're going to be working a tour of my guitar tech, huh?
I just wanted to talk to you about a few things, for example, guitar strings you use, the type of guitar strings you use while playing.
Oh yeah, I use steel round 12.
And I also wanted to know about the kind of amps you use on stage.
Yeah, I use a hot rodded 412 cab.
I also wanted to tell you about a phobia that I have and that I hope would not be a problem on tour.
Go ahead there, Oliver. I mean, BB.
The only thing is, that I cannot handle or be close to wet towels.
Jesus Christ, not again.
Yeah, actually, when I was a young boy in Munich, I got involved in a severe towel snapping incident, and my body got scarred. So I hope this is not a problem.
No, that won't be a problem.
Okay, Tilt, nice talking to you. And I really look forward to having coffee with you soon.
All right, nice talking to you, Ollie.
Ciao.
See you later, motherfucker. Where the fuck do they find these people? God damn. Yeah, Ma, Christmas just ain't the same without you. Yeah, me and Johnny's going to a Christmas party. Wish you could go. Yeah. All right, well, Merry Christmas. Talk to you soon. Bye.
Too, man. Well, yeah, we've really decorated the place up around here for Christmas. Yeah, we're gonna actually get ready to open some presents here as soon as he gets back. But he went to the grocery store. Yeah, we'll be heading over as soon as he gets back though. He's actually looking forward to meeting everybody at the label. Yeah. Oh, he's here now, so we'll be over. So again, just a little. All right. Okay. Yeah.
That's right, Bill.
Yeah, it is, Till. Sorry about that, sir. Just
Tell Springfield to pour them fancy goddamn rump range and umbrella drinks down the drain, because we're drinking Tilt style tonight.
But anyways, yeah, as soon as we get down here, we'll be heading right over. All right? Okay. Damn, Till, why'd you have to be so crass like that? I was talking about
that motherfucker. He chose
this too, you know.
Hey, I didn't ask to be here.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did.
What? Well, motherfucker. Yeah, Merry Christmas, motherfucker. Sorry, Johnny.
That's all right, Till. Anyways, that's enough of the apologies. But we are cutting into precious drinking time, so give me one of them drinks you've been talking about.
Now you're talking Tilt's language. But first you need to go in another room, because one thing about this drink is nobody knows what the fuck's in it.
I thought you told me it was just eggnog.
Oh, this ain't just eggnog. This is Grnion County eggnog. It turned the rectum inside out.
Well, I don't want a lot to happen to me, so don't make mine too strong, because you know I only drink once or twice a year.
Oh, girly boy wants a faggy umbrella drink.
Now just make the fucking drink, Till.
Yeah. This is a drink to put hair on Ethel Merman's balls, so hold on tight, buddy.
Hey, just before we get drinks, here, Till, I want to give you a little something to bottle away.
All right, buddy.
Yeah.
Oh, you didn't have to go and do that, Johnny.
Sure I did, man. Christmas only comes once a year.
You're all right, motherfucker.
Well, I hope you like it.
Man. Oh, goodness gracious. Oh, monogram!
Hell yeah.
I always dreamed of having one of these.
Well, try it on.
How's it look, Peckerwood?
You look like a star, Till. You look like a star.
you know, Johnny, I got you a little something, too.
Oh, you didn't have to do that.
Yeah. There you go, mother.
Oh, no. What could this be? What do we got? A dirty book.
Hey!
Thanks, Till.
Yeah. I figured you needed a new fuck book, since them ones under your bed had more DNA on them than a damn genetic laboratory.
Oh, I spilled shampoo on those a while back.
Yeah, sure you did, Ivan, pumping off.
No, really. But anyways, let's have a pull off of one of these drinks you made.
Yeah. Merry Christmas, motherfucker.
Cheers, brother.
Cheers, brother.
This ain't half bad, Till.
Yeah, wait about 10 minutes, you cocky prick.
Oh! I think I'm gonna die, Till.
Oh, you ain't gonna die, but you better get about 10 pairs of undershorts and keep that bucket handy.
Oh, I have the shits, too?
Shits ain't the word for it, motherfucker.
Why did you say, Till?
Oh, well, the first time I drank this, I did get very ill. But now I prepare by eating a shitload of cheese that coats my gut quite well. You're gonna be alright though, buddy. You'll be alright next time.
There ain't gonna be next time, Till. I can't make it to that party with you, man.
What's that? Oh, that's bullshit, motherfucker. I've been waiting all week for this fucking party.
I know you have, Till. You're gonna have to go by yourself, man. You'll be fine.
Come on, man. Don't push that on me, man. You'll be alright. Here, grab your jacket. I'll get you a hunk of cheese and an aspirin, man. We'll be alright, alright? Very important.
This party is important, man. This is pretty important to you.
Right.
Who's ready to party?
Yeah!
I want to thank each and one of you for a great, great year at Elite Entertainment,
And here's to another great year.
All right. Woo!
All right, who's ready for some music?
Yeah!
Strike up the band!
Hi, we're the elite here to please you tonight.
Yeah.
Be sure and eat some of that rice pilaf. It's a great San Francisco treat.
Yeah!
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle bells all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride on a one-horse herpin' sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle bells all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride on a one-horse herpin' sleigh. What a great time we're having the new year coming up. You know, it's going to be cosmic, entering the second year of the year 2000. Just we had the turn of the century last year, and here we are doing it all over again. Hope you love it. Get in there and tip your waitress. She'll love you for it. She might even go put you to bed. Hope you're having a good time tonight, because we are too. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle bells all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride on a one-horse herpin' sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle bells all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride on a one-horse herpin' sleigh.
Johnny! Good to see you!
How you doing, Mr. Springfield?
Good to
Merry
see
Christmas.
Alright, thanks. Alright. Merry Christmas. You must be Tilt.
Hey, Mr. Springfield! Merry Christmas, motherfucker!
Well, thank you very much. Tilt, I'd like you to meet the staff of Elite Entertainment here.
How you doing?
Everybody, please welcome Tilt McGillis to the Elite Entertainment family.
Hi,
Tilt! Alright, ladies. Who's ready to kiss a muscle toe?
Okay, you guys ready to check out some music?
Sure.
Hell yeah!
Let's check out this band, man. They're really good.
All right.
I want to dedicate this next song to my ex-fiancée, Judy, that miscarried with my baby over at the shrimp scampi table. Here we go.
What's going on in here, motherfucker?
Oh, I was just shaving.
You should be ruling.
Could you please close the door? Thought I was busted pumping off again. I don't know better than to do that.
Mr.
Nasty. You don't believe what I just fucking saw in there.
What's that?
The lead singer of this band, the twin brothers in there fucking jerking it like a Chinaman. Yeah.
Hey, I wonder who that could be, man.
You guys gonna answer? You want me to answer?
Go ahead, answer that door.
All right.
Oh my God, it's Leon Sturgis.
God damn. Yeah, kind of made a fool of myself last night passing out when Leon hit the door there.
It's a party. Who cares?
I never thought I'd see you there when I meet Leon.
You get to meet all kinds of people in this kind of business, too. The whole life's changing.
That Leon Turgis is a real virgin killer, isn't he?
Oh, yeah, he got more cherries than George Washington.
Yeah, he popped a few cherries, hasn't he?
He sure has.
So far, Tilt's had a pretty good time in the big city, but things are about to get as weird as a cat with three assholes.
About what, T-Bone?
Actually, it's T-Back, and
here to warn you that someone that's very close to you is jealous of you, and I'm afraid they're going to try and sabotage your career.
Who is it?
I'm sorry, Tilt, but I can't tell you that. The only thing I know is that it's someone that's very close to you. It's most likely a friend of yours, so all I can say is just keep an eye out.
Why would somebody want to ruin my career?
Because you're an asshole, Tilt. I'm just kidding you. Little bare-ass superhero humor there.
Yeah, mate.
No, actually, I'm probably not the first person that's told you this, but you got a very promising career ahead of you. I feel that you'll be a big star in the very near future. And that's making someone very, very jealous, and I hate to say it, but I think someone's trying to kill you, Till.
Anybody tries to kill me, they're gonna get a serious fucking ass whooping for me. Well, they better not try to fucking kill me. Anyway.
You just keep an eye out, Till? And chances you'll be fine.
Alright, I will, T-Mac. Thanks for the warning.
Sure thing, Till. Well, I probably ought to get going.
Alright, mate.
Oh, another thing, Till, I just remembered. Yeah. Make sure you always recycle. Actually, let me get that bottle from you, too. I get a nickel for these down at the sheet metal place.
Yeah, buddy.
Yeah. Okay, well, thanks, Till. You take care now, and remember what I said. You keep an eye out for somebody, okay?
All right, buddy. Thanks for the warning.
Okay, bye.
The fuck was that all about? What a freaky ass fucking dream that was. No. Oh. The fuck? Oh. Thank God that was some freaky ass fucking dream right there. Maybe that was a premonition. Maybe I better wash my fucking ass. Hot damn, where the fuck's my fucking package?
Are you Tilt McGillis?
Think I ain't?
Sign here.
Alright. Get it. There you go, buddy.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, brother. Hot damn, my x-ray specs. Aha! Oh yeah, buddy. Oh my God, he's jacking off!
Why did I have to fucking see that?
Ooh. What's up, Tilt? I was just doing shaving, you know?
Nothing, buddy.
Go for some turkey right now.
Machine, I'm gonna fucking choke. Hey, Mr. Springfield, this is Tilt McGillis. That was a hell of a Christmas party, man. Got drunk as shit. Woo! Hey, you wouldn't be trying to kill me, would you? Okay. Well, I just wanted to make sure, man. All right, thanks, man. Hello. Leon! Leon Turgis? What the hell are you doing? You're where? Bike Fest? The hell's all that all about? Really? Beer, huh? Alright, Leon, yeah, I'll be over. We'll party it up, buddy. Talk to you later, man. Hot damn, hot damn. Hey, Johnny! Leon Turgis just called me. He's up at Bike Fest.
Oh, really?
Yeah. You want to go, man?
No. I missed a spot shaving. Right, I got to shave again.
Okay. By the way, man, you got a drip of mayonnaise on your slacks. You might want to get that up.
Oh, I'm sorry. Messy sandwich, boy.
Oh, yeah. Hot asses, hot bikes, big tits, and cold beer. Sounds like a good time to me.
Hey, Till, open up. Do whatever you gotta do to get me in this goddamn place. This town makes me nervous.
Okay, I'll beep you in.
Goddamn beer. Oh, hell yeah. Man, all that city driving made me fucking thirsty. Yeah, Leon, hell of a place you got here. Nothing like that country living. You know, like that song you got country about. I love that song. You know, like, why bang a city girl when you have fall in love with the country about?
Wow, I'm surprised you remember that song, Tilt. I must have put that one out 25 years ago.
Yeah, March of 75 to be exact. I remember that day I bought that album. Look at me now, standing here next to you. Can't believe it.
Star in country music. Now, everybody thought I was finished created my own style of country music.
Yeah, you sure did. You got the sweetest voice box in the business, buddy.
And you know what else, too? I plan on staying on top for a long time, and nobody's going to get in my way. That's why I'm going to have to kill you, Tilt.
Hey, you better rethink this, motherfucker.
Freeze, Douglas! FBI agent Stephen Mitchell, put your fucking hands in the air!
Holy fucking shit. You fucking prick, you shot my ball.
Ball? Shouldn't that be plural? Is it balls?
No. I lost the other one in a barbed wire fence jumping contest.
Oh.
Get the fuck over here. Son of a bitch.
Yeah, Turgis ain't the stupid hillbilly you thought I was. I've been on to you since day one, motherfucker. Just cause I like your music doesn't I trust you. Son of a bitch. I'm gonna go home and shit on every one of your goddamn LPs.
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you fucking say will and all that shit be held against you.
Thanks, Mitchell. I owe you one, buddy.
You owe me 12.
12 pack of fucking beer as soon as we get out of here.
Let's go right now. Fuck it.
Swats will pick him up.
Bunkos. For a minute. Rearrange your furniture downstairs here. It's a little binding.
Sure is a nice day, isn't
it? Yeah, it is. Coming in, coming in. Somebody step on a duck. Yeah, Johnny, this is life, ain't it?
Nice day like this. Sand pool.
Yeah. Song on the radio.
You got your hit song on the radio.
Yeah, they've been wiring that sumbitch out, ain't they?
Hey, let them keep playing. More exposure. Until it's been an honor working with you. You know, I never lost faith in you the whole time.
Yeah, Johnny, I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart. You helped me out, man. You got me out of the country, brought me up to the big city, got me a song on the radio, swimming in a pool. Here's to our success.
Here's to the future.
This is a lie.
Damn phone, man. Never stops.
Busy man, Johnny. Busy man.
Hello. Mr. Springfield, how you doing? Good. The song's what? What was that again? I don't think I understood you. It is. That's great. That is great. Oh, I'll pass that along. Oh, thank you. Okay. You too. Bye.
What's up? What's up?
Tilt.
Yo.
That was Mr. Springfield.
No shit.
Your song Love Dublin?
Yep.
It's debuting tomorrow. Number one on the Billboard chart.
Goddamn. Woo-hoo!
Hey, all right, we made it. Out of here.
Oh, yeah. Man. I gotta do something. I gotta do something. I promise somebody I was gonna do something when this happens, if it ever happens. I'll be right back.
Take your time, Tilt. Take a little bit of time.
I might be gone about a day, but I'll be back.
That's all right. We'll see you tomorrow. You have a good time. Hey, be careful. You're a star now.
Yeah.
Oh, what a surprise. You should have called us something. I didn't know you were coming for a visit.
Yeah, I just thought I'd drop by.
Well, I would have had something prepared.
Oh, that's all right. Remember what I told you before I left town?
No, I don't remember.
Well, here in about 10 minutes till 10 on the radio, you're going to hear something. It's going to be a big surprise.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
What?
This high low country music singer is definitely on his way to superstar. This week's number one song is Tilt McGillis.
That's you!
Hello.
Oh my god! Oh, that's you! My god, I can't believe that's you! Oh my god, you sound so great! I can't believe it! You made it!
I'm a country star.
Oh, I'm so proud of you! I'm so proud of you!
Johnny was a schoolboy with a hood to spill Speedo soul. Love me do, I think it was from there, didn't take him long. Got himself a guitar, used to play every night. And now he's in a rock and roll outfit and everything's alright. Don't you know? Johnny told his mama, hey mama, I'm going away. I'm gonna hit the big town, gonna be a big star someday, yeah. Mama came to the door with a tear drop in her eye. Johnny said, don't cry, mama, smile and wave goodbye. Don't you know? As long as